Welcome to the second day of the Leadership Energy Summit Asia, day two. Before we bring on board the esteemed speakers from the other parts of the world to share with us their findings and the great work they've been doing all these years, let us do a quick recap of what happened yesterday. People often ask me, Sabri, why do you spend your life in this work that you do? It's like the core of my existence. Meaning to say, why? I think the tone of the language question was, why do you spend your time wasting your life doing this work? I mean, is a natural question to be asked, actually, because at my age now, the work that I do, I've worked with so many kinds of people, so many different levels of ages. I've yet to come across a person, a fresh graduate especially, whom when I ask, what do you want to be when you are 5 years from now? Not even one person says, sir, I want to become a leadership facilitator or program developer like you. Not even one. So they always want to be chief of HR. They always want to be, you know, captain of a consulting industry or banking industry or telecommunications boss or oil and gas. Never once would they say, I want to become a leadership development person like you. So, I have no issues with that. It's good because I have less people to compete with. It's good for Iclif. But seriously, why do I do this? This is my personal story. It's a very simple one, but it's very meaningful for me. And I hope it applies to you too. As with most people, I started my work wanting to become chief of HR. Maybe not for Maybank, not good enough for that, but for another smaller organization, perhaps if I get lucky. I worked very hard. I worked my bum out. So what happened somewhere along the way? Because when I spoke to Nipun Mehta, interviewed him on video recording 2 days ago, he too wanted to become a tennis player, a tennis pro, or a Himalayan guru. But as you can see, he ended up being neither one. So what happened? I read the biography of Tom Selleck, the Magnum PI actor. Don't know why I'm intrigued by him, because I think I look like him. So I too discovered that he too is one of those people whose life's ambitions came to naught. Because his real ambition is to become, check this out, a baseball player. Same is true with Billy Joel, a baseball player, but end up being successful in other areas. Successful, yes, but it's never their lifelong or childhood ambition. So this is my story. I joined my previous life. It all started with this small little company. I don't know if you guys are familiar with this company. It's called Petronas. I was there. I was in previous companies before, but when I was informed there is a vacancy in Petronas, so I dropped everything at that age to be a part of the Petronas story. And I was successful in the interview. I was asked to report for duty on March 16, 1994. I remember that day because that's the day I report for work and because that's the third day of Hari Raya. My non-Muslim colleagues in this room, you know we Muslims fast for 1 month in the month of Ramadan. You know that, right? But you also know in Malaysia, we go on a binge for the next 3 months. So the third day of Hari Raya is still very much Hari Raya for me. I was going up the elevator, that Menara Daya Bumi level 22. Where is Shazlina? She's here. Level 22, Menara Daya Bumi, reporting Tuan Haji Muhammad Jurimi, the recruitment manager then. And because I was an experienced recruit, I was not given a year, but 6 months probation. I don't mind telling you guys, for the next 6 months, until today, those 6 months were the most horrendous 6 months of my life. You want to know why? Because I was made to report to a guy who was created by God to hate me. So when our eyes met, it's like, aha, you are the one I was born to hate. So I'm going to hate you. You know, to the best of my abilities. And hated me, he did. It got so bad that I turned to, I just picked up the phone and called my friend. I was younger then and cheaper then. I'm still cheap, but I was cheaper then. So I could get a job just like that. So he said, bro, Sab, you, Sabri, come and report for me to my company at the beginning of next month. And you get your paperwork done on your side, you leave, because I was still on that stage where I could just walk out anytime. I say, okay, I'll get the paperwork done on my side and I'll join you next month. Yeah, that sounds good. And I turned to my colleague next to me and I told her a secret. Don't tell anybody but I'm leaving. So lesson number one for the day. If it is a secret, don't tell anybody. Especially your most trusted, closest, best friend. Okay, be very careful. Because 2 days later, the phone rang. 4801. I still remember the extension number. Can you believe that? 25 years later, extension 4801. 4801 is Tan Sri President's office. He called me up. Not him, his PA, of course. He called me up. Says, Sabri, Tan Sri wants to see you now. I say, why do you want to see me now? I mean, the speech is not ready. It's not due for another couple of days. He wants to see you now. Come up now. Boom. So, okay. So I went up. Go into the room. Sat down. Then it hit me, something weird with this picture, something not quite right with this picture, because at my age, at my level, at that point in time, my career, when I saw the big man, it was always his PA on my right and my GM on my left. At that point in time, neither one of them was there. So if I was Spider-Man, there was this warning back of my head, danger, danger, danger. I couldn't do anything about it, I was there. He looked at me and says, give me a minute. Said, yeah, by all means, take all the time you need, you're the boss. So, okay, sit there. So, he finished his work, changed his glasses, looked at me again. How are you, young man? I'm okay. I'm fine. And how are you, sir? So I don't get into conversation. He says, half smiling, he looked at me and says, I'm fine too, thank you for asking. So are you happy? Of course I am. It's like, WTF, of course I'm happy. Can't you see? He says, you sure? Yes, I am. He says, if you're happy, then why are you leaving? I said, well, okay. Right, I was a speechwriter then, so I could conjure words up quite quickly then. The process has slowed down quite a bit through the years, but at that time I was a bit faster on my feet and on my thoughts. So the words kept flowing. I said, well, my short-term, medium-term, long-term aspirations for my career are better served if I work in a small, medium-sized industry rather than MNC like Petronas, blah, 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 and the words kept flowing. He just looked at me and just cut through the bull and says, is it because of Mr. XYZ? I just went, he caught me on the wrong foot again. I said, yes, it is. In another 2 minutes, the man caught me lying twice. That's why he's the president. So I said, yes. I said, would it help you if you were to report direct to your Mr. ABC? I say, Tan Sri, that's the best gift anybody can give me at this point in my life. Thank you so much, sir. Picked up my file, gathered my papers, I was about to leave. I said, no, sit down. Do you know why you should be here? You know, we are going to Formula One very soon. We'll go around the world checking out the tours and creating our own team very, very soon. Did you know that? I didn't know that, sir. And if you're lucky, you behave yourself and not leave your mind. You consider putting you on that team. Well, wow, this is good stuff. And we're going to Sudan, we're going to South Africa, we're going to many kinds of stuff. We're buying half of engine, we're doing all kinds of stuff. Vietnam coming through, the oil and gas coming through in Vietnam. That's good. This is why young people, I was young then. I was young at one time in my life, you know. And I had a bit more hair than I do now. He says, that's why young people like you need to stay in this company. She says, okay, I get it. So are we done? She says, yes, we are. So I picked up my file. I was about halfway out the door, a room about, pretty big room, certainly bigger than the room I have now. And I was about to leave the room. He looked at me again and says, so Sabi, you are staying, right? He says, yes, sir, I am staying. Thank you very much. When I left the room, I went to my table, switched off the computer, dumped my files on the table, went out, crossed the little bridge behind Dayabumi into the central market, and I had some tea, my friends, smoked cigarette, more tea, more friends, more cigarettes. About 3:15 the same day I drove home, and I went home. and I was drunk with emotion. When he passed away very early one morning, aside from the family members, I was one of the earliest person to show up at his house to help prepare the body for burial. And I cried like I had lost my own father. When I left Petronas to join Iclif, I gave the man 18 years of my life. Not just 18 excellent, impeccable years, I think, even if I do say so myself, and I do. He gave me 5 minutes of his time. I gave him almost 20 years of my life. That's what leadership can do for you. It may sound cheesy to some of you guys, but it worked for me. If it worked for me, I think it can work for most of you, your people as well. So leadership is not something nice to have or nice to do because it bodes well to do good to another human being, but to me, it's also impactfully important for good business to flourish. That's what it is. And to be a bit more on the personal side, at our age right now, the work that we do, me personally, with all humility, and my colleagues, this is true for my colleagues as well. We always get invites to be permanent members of our client organization. We always say no. And people always ask us why. Because I love Karen, Rajiv, and the team that we have in Iclif. It's not a big team. It's not the best team in the world. But it's a team that I love most in the world. And we work throughout weekends. So back to my earlier point, ladies and gentlemen, it's not just good to be good to people, but it's good to be good. It's good for business as well. So this leadership thing doesn't cost you money. But how come when we ask people about great leadership, the answer is 0, 1, or 2? And we spend so much money on great leadership development, the answer should be more than 0, 1, 2. That's the point. Yeah? 1,000, Rajiv said yesterday, 1,200 books are written about leadership in the English language alone. And he's guilty of adding to that pile also. Yeah? So we should be doing better than that. All right, now, yesterday we talked a lot about leadership. And my simple point about leadership is this. People often ask me, so Sami, what is your idea of a perfect leadership model? I get that question asked of us. We get that question asked of us all the time. What is your idea of perfect leadership? To me, the idea of perfect leadership is exemplified or manifested very easily. Motherhood. One word. Motherhood. The fathers in this room, my apologies. That includes me. Let me tell you why. Because the moment a mother conceives a child, not even giving birth to the child yet, upon conception, everything about this woman's life, including what to drink, what not to drink, the shoes that she can or cannot be wearing, revolves around the existence and the constant nurturing of the body, that living thing inside of her. Now, to the mothers in this room, or parents, guys included, fathers, yeah? How many of us, when we decided to have a baby, we turn to each other and say, when we grow up, we become 65, 75 years old, too old to work, our children will come to us and give us a $1.5 million check each so that we can all live in retirement in peace. How many of us did that? Seriously? Not even one person? Right, not even me. But yet again, let me ask you another question. How many of us can guarantee that when our children grow up, they will become good human beings? Guaranteed. Guaranteed. Anybody in this room can say that? Guaranteed. You cannot guarantee. And yet you have children. So to the risk experts or the specialists in this room, if you were asked to put up a paper to present to your board, your management committee, what would the ROI on parenthood be? Pretty low, don't you think? Would you recommend parenthood as something that you guys should go into then? Of course not. Even the mothers in this room will go, now that you put it that way, sir, let me think my decision again. No, just don't do that. The point I'm trying to raise is very simple. Leadership is like that, too. There's no guarantee that people that we lead, that we nurture, that we contribute towards their growth, can turn out to be the exact same people that we think in their minds they should become. But that doesn't mean that it should stop us from giving all we got to make sure they grow up big, handsome if you can, good and successful. That's what leadership is all about. And what do we ask of our children? Just to be good, just to be successful. That's all the reward that we need. What does or what did Madiba Mandela ask of his people? Just be good. What does he want from them? Does he get anything from them? That's what great leadership is all about. And yet, the first thing we, you know, leadership is a funny thing. The first instance you say you want to do something good, there is that voice that you hear, sometimes from within, most times from without. Are you serious? I mean, we ourselves, Rajiv included, jokingly asked Nipun yesterday, what do? How do you pay your bills? Like, are you serious, dude? This thing you're talking about? So that part of us is always kind of, that cynicism always kicks in. So the greatest challenge of great leadership right now, to me, in the work that I do, I see that getting over that first level of cynicism is the most immediate and most difficult thing for leaders to do right now. But, you know, in the lives that we lead right now, the times that we live in, the drone attacks, the 9/11s, the ISIS issue that we have, the perpetual Israeli conflict with Palestinians, you can't help but be a little bit cynical. So how do we get over all that and project good leadership in the great work that we do right now? I cannot pretend to be able to encapsulate yesterday's learnings on my own. I need help to do this.